This video will demonstrate a new installation of PI Buffer Subsystem version 4.3. The scenario presented in the video will also apply if you are upgrading from a previous version and buffering was never configured on the machine. To start with, let's take a look at some of the system requirements. I have here the PI Buffer Subsystem software requirements from the PI Live library. As you can see, PI Buffer Subsystem supports both 32-bit and 64-bit client and server Windows operating systems, starting from Windows Server 2003 SP2. For the destination PI Data Archive server, the version requirement is that it must be version 3.4.375 or later. As always, we recommend running the latest version for the best performance. Finally, if you're configuring buffering for PI API-based interfaces, you will need to use PI ICU version 1.4.15 or later. And if you're configuring buffering for AF SDK or PI SDK products, you will need PI AF Client version 2014 or PI SDK version 2014, respectively. So let's take a look at the current configuration of my interface machine. Here in PI ICU, you'll notice that I already have two PI interfaces configured and running. However, if I open the buffering option, you'll notice that I currently have no buffering mechanism configured. Keep in mind that since this is an installation, a system reboot or service stoppage may be necessary. So these two interfaces that I have here may need to be stopped during the installation. So when you're doing the installation, make sure you have the appropriate downtime scheduled or you have interface failover configured to minimize the data downtime necessary for the installation. All right, so let's show where to get the install kits. You'll want to navigate your browser to the OSIsoft tech support page at techsupport.osisoft.com. Once there, go to Downloads. Once the download page has loaded, you can type in PI Buffer Subsystem for the product name and click Search. You'll notice that as of the recording of this video, we get these results returned. Since I want to configure buffering for PI interfaces, I'm going to download the PI Interface Configuration Utility, version 1.4.16.79a. If you are configuring buffering for PI SDK or AF SDK, it's currently recommended that you download the PI Asset Framework Client 2014 R2 SP1 Install Kit, since this contains the latest version of PI Buffer Subsystem, as well as the PI SDK. Okay, so I already have the install kit downloaded, and it's saved to my D drive install kits folder. Let's go ahead and get started with the installation. I'm going to right-click the install kit and run as an administrator. It's going to prompt me for a location to unzip the install files, so I'm just going to put it into the same D drive install kits folder. Once the files are unzipped, the splash screen will show that PI Buffer Subsystem is one of the modules that will be upgraded. I already have an older version of PI Buffer Subsystem installed on the machine, but since I never configured it for buffering, as stated before, the installation procedure will be the same as a new installation. The installation will then show me which services need to be stopped for the installation. So if I click Next, you'll notice that it also shows me that my two interfaces will also need to be stopped. Once the installation is complete, the installation will restart the services. So once again, please make sure you have either the appropriate downtime scheduled or interface failover configured to minimize your data downtime. Now that the installation has finished, you'll notice that all of my services have been restarted, including my two PI interfaces for OPC-DA. So in the final splash screen, we can see that PI Buffer Subsystem was successfully installed. If you're configuring buffering for PI interfaces, you can continue by watching the video Configure PI Buffer Subsystem for PI API Interfaces. Otherwise, if you're configuring buffering for PI SDK or AF SDK clients, you can watch the video Configure PI Buffer Subsystem for SDK Buffering.